Hello friends, here in this video we are going to see the methods for reducing stress concentration. Now, the method used for stress concentration, it can be explained with a diagram. Now, suppose we have a material or an object in which the area changes suddenly. Now, suppose we have an object in which the area decreases suddenly, like here we are having sharp corners. So, because of the presence of the sharp corners, stresses will accumulate at this junction, and because of the stress concentration here, the material will break from this junction. So to avoid the stress concentration at this region, we can modify the shape of this component, like instead of decreasing the area suddenly, we can decrease it gradually, like this. Now, as we can see from both the diagram, at first the area was decreasing suddenly, now it is decreasing gradually, so the stress distribution is more uniform here. The stress will flow at a uniform rate. So this is one of the method of reducing the stress concentration, that is by changing the area gradually instead of suddenly. Next, in the second example, now suppose I'll take the example of this case only, that at first we are having the sudden change in area, now we have reduced it gradually. Next, suppose if this radius, this is called as the fillet radius. Now take an example that if this fillet radius is very large, and when we have no space to make an object of this large radius, then another method of reducing the stress concentration is Now, another method to reduce the stress concentration is, instead of decreasing the area, what we are doing is producing small holes or grooves, or we can say notches. So because of the presence of these notches, stresses won't be accumulated only at the junction, but they would be distributed uniformly. That is, the stress will flow along the holes and then it will flow along this junction. This is the flow of stress. So this is called as the uniform stress distribution. So this is one more method of reducing the stress concentration. Next, apart from this, if suppose we have an object inside that object, if there is a hole present, internal hole is there in this object, then the stress will be concentrated along this hole. So here the stress gets concentrated, and when the load is applied, this object would be failing here. So to avoid this, what we can do is, instead of providing a single hole, along with this hole we can introduce smaller holes close to it. So now when we have small holes close to the hole which is here already there, so the stress gets distributed along each of them uniformly, like this. The stress will go on flowing. Stress concentration is removed. It will be more uniform. So these are the methods of stress concentration. Next, let me show the last method of stress concentration, in which we have an object which is having threads. Now, suppose we have an object which has threads like this shown in the diagram. Now, suppose this shank, it has a diameter of DO. Next, similarly, at the outer end, the threads also have their major diameter as DO, called as the nominal diameter. Next, here we have a minimum diameter as well, which is called as DC, core diameter. Now, when this threaded member is subjected to load, suppose if the load is tensile, I am just taking an example that if the load is tensile, then since nominal diameter is greater than the core diameter, so nominal area will be greater than the core area. So core area is minimum, so stress will be maximum at the core area. Means this is called as the core area where we are having the core diameter, called as the minimum diameter. So when the load is applied, the object will not fail at the shank, it will fail at the threaded portion, that is these threads, they will break. So to avoid this failure, one of the method is to reduce the shank diameter and make it equal to the core diameter, so that there is no stress concentration. Otherwise, there is stress concentration here. This is stress concentration in threads. So to avoid this, the preferred method is now. To avoid the failure, one of the preferred method is to reduce DO and make it equal to DC. Here if I can see, this diameter is, I'll keep it as D, and this is DC, the core diameter. So this diameter D is equal to DC, that is the shank diameter is equal to the core diameter. Now when we are applying the tensile load, which is load P, because of this, the stress will not be accumulated in the threaded section, because core diameter, this diameter is extended up to the shank, so the stress distribution will be more uniform. That is, same amount of stress will be accumulated throughout the object. So with this, the breaking of the thread becomes difficult. So this is one of the preferred method, and the other method would be to drill a hole, keeping the dimension same. We would be drilling a hole inside the shank, so that when this hole is drilled, suppose the diameter of the hole is small d suffix h, so because of the hole here, the stress is not concentrated in the threaded part, but it is also concentrated in the hole, so the stress distribution becomes uniform. So in this video, we have seen the methods for reducing stress concentration.